Catholic News Magazine.
Litania do ran Chrystusowych.
Litany to Christ's wounds.
Chwała Chrystusowym ranom.
Glory to Christ's wounds.
Źródłom objawionym.
Sources of presented source.
Krew Boga.
From which the blood of God flows.
Ta krew jest strumieniem róż i balsamu.
This blood is a stream of roses and balm, a river of sweet honey.
Jak indyjski
kamień. It's priceless like Indian stone.
Chwała Chrystusowym ranom,
glory to Christ's wounds, which are the key to life
i kluczem śmierci,
and the key to death
i kluczem naszej wiedzy,
and the key to our knowledge
i kluczem naszej nadziei,
and the key
i kluczem
to our hope
przepaści,
and the key to an abyss
Dawidów,
and the key of David's.
Chwała Chrystusowym ranom.
Glory to Christ's wounds.
I gwoździom
and
wbitym
nails
w ręce i nogi Boga.
Driven into the hands and limbs of God.
W jego bok.
And the spire driven into his side.
I
because both the nails and the spire opened
tak
the gate of heaven.
I taranów,
like the stroke of sword opens the gate of a besieged city.
Chwała Chrystusowym
glory to Christ's
ranom,
wounds,
które są gniazdem
which are
aniołów,
a nest of angels,
i ulem
and
serafinów,
the hive of seraphs,
i gołębnikiem cherubinów,
and the pigeon house of cherubim, and an alley in paradise gardens, and the path of sheep under the stick
swoje otwarte
of shepherd.
Rany,
make your open wounds a corridor through which we'll get out from the labyrinth of our
herds.
Splice
streets
onto musical mountains where clad in your blood like in a wedding clothes. We will sing in a choir of golden books. Let's come back to the Christ's wounds,
jak jelenie do wiecznych
like
źródeł.
Deers to eternal sources.
Klęknijmy nad ich
let's
brzegiem
kneel down over their
banks
nasze głowy bend our
nad ciernistą głębokością
over
krwi.
The depth of
chwała
blood. Glory to Christ.
Cierpiącej kiści winogron.
A suffering bunch of grapes
wina,
pressed
z
in a compressor of wine
do naszych
from which
ust,
a stream to our poor mouth an
krew.
Immaculate stream of blood has flown.
W czas Wielkiego Postu,
during the time
pokupu,
of Lent, during the time of Lent and waiting for resurrection,
Kiszkis,
you are welcomed by Jerzy Kiszkis
with
the poem of Roman
Brandstaetter's
The Litany to the Christ's Wounds. And now you're welcome to look at the report about the visit of the copy of the miraculous St. Mary of Częstochowa to our diocese. It started on the 4th of May 1985 and in the Gdańsk diocese on the 4th January 1988. You will see the celebrations of commencing the visit. They were organized in the greatest church in Poland with the participation of Primate of Poland, the Basilica of St. Mary in Gdansk.
Matko, wiem,
Welcome in Gdańsk, our mother. We know that you are always with us. At the Vistula in August 1920 in lagers in different countries. And now in such a difficult period of the Polish nation, you are always with us. We want to do everything, whatever your son tells us, and your Lord. Be with us, Mary, all the time. Support and bring us joy, us and our homeland.
Pan z Tobą, błogosławionaś Ty między niewiastami.
Tam w domu świętej Elżbiety,
there in the house of St. Elizabeth, in a joyful welcome of these women, is contained the evangelization, the good news,
którą przekazuje Maria niosąca which Jezusa Chrystusa.
Is transcended by Mary who carries Jesus Christ. So to understand Marii, the visit of St. Mary is to understand what for she came here to Gdańsk. In a difficult time of winter day, a day of price increases, a day which is not free from our human troubles. She came because she wants to be among its her people. Whether she comes to the faithful only, or whether she all the time carrying Christ, does she only come to those who are waiting for her? Mary comes now to everybody. To all.
Kiedy więc Jezus ujrzał matkę,
so when Jesus saw his mother and his disciple standing beside her, he said, woman, this is your son, and then said to his disciple, this is your mother. They came on the invitation of French President Mitterrand to Paris, the laureates of Nobel Prize from all over the world, and discussed about future. But one cannot talk about future without thinking about past and present. That's why they came to Poland, to Auschwitz. They came most of them were the Jews, the nation who suffered most during the Second World War. Lech Wałęsa came as well. After the presentation of report from Auschwitz, you will be able to see a small event, the history of disappearing of a stone from the parish of Divine Providence in Zaspa. Nobel Prize winners in Auschwitz. If one wants to talk about the 21st century, one has to see Auschwitz. On the 17th January 1988, the author of these words, world-known Jewish writer, laureate of Nobel Prize, Ela Wisel, came to the Auschwitz lager. He came not alone, but together with 30 members of a delegation of Paris Conference destined to think about the most important dangers that are in front of the humanity in the beginning of 21st century. The Polish Nobel Prize winner, Lech Wałęsa, came as well. The president of Oslo Prize, Nobel Prize Committee, Egil Orvik, then Maurice Goldstein, the secretary general of International Auschwitz Committee and main counselor to the president of France, Jacques Attali. All the Nobel Prize winners walked very solemnly along the streets of Auschwitz. As a son of this land, which has been stigmatized by Auschwitz, praying together with you, praying homage to all the murdered here, I'd like to, in a very particular way, bend my head in the face of drama of the Jewish people, which happened here. We believe that those who fell are in another reality, and perhaps even better than we can judge the world where these crimes could be committed. Lech Wałęsa, my friend. This is a shortening of speech given by Ela Wisel. You are a Pole and I am a Jew. We are very close to me. We have to remember that our children be given the feeling of dignity and hope. Here one has to hope. I thought when I came here at night that the evil is unlimited. I asked myself, is it the end of the Jewish nation? Is it the end of the humanity? Is it the end of the world? Practically, what kind of world has finished here? We have to rebuild now. A world where it is true that people are free. Regardless of our faith, we are the children of the same God. Lech Wałęsa, we will not forget about you. You are our representative here, and you will be your representative in the whole world. We will speak, we will remind, end with sufferings. In the spring 1987, Gdańsk has been preparing itself for the visit of the Pope. The local council in Zaspa, where the main celebration was being prepared, has invited to its assembly the parish priest, Reverend Kazimierz Wojciechowski. During the meeting of the local council, it has been decided that on the place of meeting of the Holy Father, one will have to commemorate somehow. Still before the arrival of the Holy Father, I have been shown a place by the city's architect, where one could eventually put a commemorating stone.
Również wskazano mi konkretny głaz, kamień.
I was also shown a definite 20-ton weighing stone, which could eventually be
upamiętnienia tego miejsca.
A beginning of this commemoration monument.
Że budujemy kościół.
Taking advantage of the opportunity that we built a church on the 6th of January this year, I brought, with the help of a huge crane,
na miejsce,
that stone to the place
wskazane mi uprzednio przez Radę Osiedla.
Shown to me beforehand by the local council.
Był tam do 4 lutego.
This stone was there till the 4th of February, because on that very day, about 11 p.m.,
przybiegli na plebanie parafianie,
people came to the parish office who told me about the action of stealing of that stone. In the action of stealing, a huge crane took part. A truck, a Kamaz truck from a state transport company, WPT, from Rzeszów, a wagon with civilian registration and a police car. Fiat 125. Reverend Wojciechowski has filed a suit to the local police office. They promised to inform him about the developments. In the meantime, the stone has been found in Brentowo, in the area of transportation of Green Conservation Company. The authorities have clarified that this was not stealing, because according to the law from 1936, the owner of all stones in the country is the state. So the proprietor has came for his property, and the priest is the real thief. And this is the whole story. Among other useless things at the Gdańsk suburbs stands the tacit hero of the simple story. Now our bishop will address the city president about placing a monument which will commemorate the stay of the Holy Father. He was approaching to the slope of the Mount of Olives when very many disciples started to glorify God for all the miracles that they saw. Blessed is the King who comes on behalf of the Lord. But some of the Pharisees told him, "Teacher, tell your disciples not to do it." And he answered, "When they are silent, the stones will start shouting." Revaluation of words. This is the subject of a short talk given to us by Andrew Drabicz. There are very many strange things happening in the sphere of the Soviet world, things that were unimaginable, say, 3-4 years ago. Now it becomes a fact. The amateurs of Boris Pasternak can read for the first time in their homeland the novel of Dr. Zhivago. They can also know a great novel by Vasil Grossman about the last world war, which was arrested at the beginning of the 60s. All the copies were taken out of the author. It appears in the October Monthly. Orwell's 1984 is going to be published. Publication of thoughts by Maxim Gorky from his articles 1918 about a very critical assessment of the Soviet coup, of the Bolshevik coup of the October Revolution. We will see whether it will be fully given. There were very many other interesting things happening. In particular, I'd like to draw your attention to a short text, but touching a very painful affair, the Afghanistan affair. It ripens to a settlement. Now it is a very painful thing. The lost generation comes. In Aganiok Weekly, a story by Krupin has appeared. It was something about New Year, about a man who was completely pushed out of his saddle. We don't know about him anything, only the thing that he drinks and he cannot find a place in life. There is nothing unusual, only at the very end a short sentence comes which clarifies everything. Before going to the army, he did not drink, he was serving abroad, and now we know why he was pushed out of the saddle, why he became a drunkard. Not only him, but very many other young people, many years after Russia and the Soviet Union will have to heal the wounds, not only physical, but also psychical wounds. There is also a very sad, different story. The story about Stalin's attempt to liquidate all the managing staff of different institutions, also the cadres of Komsomol. The leaders of Komsomol arrested in 36-38, all the secretaries were subject to very brutal methods of cross-examination. There was a process of Trotskyists and Bukharin. But here it did not work. Very great party activists like Bukharin Tomsky, they were all doing things that were asked for. They were accusing one another. But these Komsomol leaders, they did not give any material against themselves. Stalin could not mount a trial of them. It is sad, but anything, it is something that supports. The young generation appeared to be less prone to Stalinist manipulation. Very many materials that show the past are very drastic. We knew very many things in Poland, not only from the Soviet sources, but anyhow the whole impression that I have from it is, from this opening of information, is very advantageous. Let God continue so that they reflect over their own past. Thinking about it, I think about a metaphor used by one of the critics. He reminded a story by Michael Zoschenko, a great Soviet novelist, about people living in a collective apartment. They lived in horrible conditions, but there was no light in that flat. They became accustomed to it. And when there was light and they saw their horrible conditions, they were shocked. So at that very moment they cut their wire not to see what happens with them. And this critic, having made a review of everything, he said, he uses this word, we will resurrect only when the wires are not cut. Let's hope it will be this way. The Church tells us to believe only those miracles which happened before the end of the death of the last apostles. The other, even well documented like those from Lourdes or Fatima, leaves to our own assessment. They can be either approved or rejected. The Church is very reluctant to assess some happenings as supernatural. We could be witness of it in relation to what happened in Medjugorje. It seems to us that everybody has his own experience, his own assessment, his own judgment. The word miracle has become a household word in our language. We often say that someone has miraculously avoided the death, or he has managed to do something as miracle. Do miracles happen then or not? I hope that these questions will be better understood after you see Wojtek. I was in Lodz at that time, and Wojtek wrote to me that he was in Lourdes and that he sees. He didn't tell me anything. He invited me to a room, took a book, and started to read it. To me, he told me, "Dearie, I see." It was something great. We were all very happy. We were crazy with joy in that small room. When I was 18, within about 3 weeks, I lost my sight. I stayed in a hospital in Gdansk, in Lodz, in Bydgoszcz. Treatment didn't help anything. I became a disabled person of the first group because of the loss of sight. The Wojtek's illness started in 1983 in August. I went to an oculist, not as with a young man who was ill, but as a kind of a social visit. I was motivated to do it because when I was returning from a cemetery, I often asked him, "What tram is coming?" And he answered, "Mother, I don't see it." Till that time he was not ill, only some kids' illnesses, but in a very mild way. We went to the hospital as a kind of a social visit with flowers. Mrs. Malinowska, the doctor, in the beginning she didn't tell me anything. After several minutes, it lasted a little bit more. Wojtek does not see with his right eye. About on the 20th August, the elder brother Tomasz returned from pilgrimage. About 2-3 meters, they were in front of one another. It was a little bit strange. They haven't seen one another for about 3 weeks. It seemed they were not recognizing them. I was a little bit surprised with it. Tomasz approaches him. "Hello, brother, I haven't recognized you." I went once more to the hospital. "What's going on with his second eye?" "Well, he'll carry corrective glasses, everything will be okay." But after my intervention, they checked that he's losing sight with his left eye as well. A thing that seemed to me something very evil for me. Now I look at it as something wonderful. It was evil in the sense that it was a reason for some kind of a cause of a breakdown. It was a ballast that made me think about suicide. In a kind of a vision, I saw Christ falling under the cross. And this falling gave me this alternative, either to get up or to fall completely. I chose the first way. I started to look at this disability in a new way. I recommenced my school, I managed to pass my maturity test, I managed to get to the university. In the beginning it was very hard, I did no braille, I had to change many customs. I had to learn to walk with the white stick. It was the only argument with which I could go to the street. This is a very fine stick. A white stick that denotes us, the blind. One could feel that Wojtek was waiting, although he never said about that. Wojtek was suffering. He very often got into some water. We were not very experienced as guides.
I was with him at home for 3 months. I was afraid of his inner life. It demoralized us to a very large extent, because till 2-3 a.m. we were talking, and then we were sleeping till 10 a.m. He started to take advantage of spoken books from a library from the blind. We were listening to those books, and I tried to stay with him at home. Not too many things were changed. I tried to make him more or less self-supporting. He moved at home very well. He could manage with everything. Some small things like cutting bread or making tea, it was a bit more difficult, but after some time he learned to do it. After coming back from the hospital in Lodz, it was in November, there was a fact, I was at home, and what am I to do? I didn't have a white stick, I didn't know the Braille alphabet, so I came to the conclusion that I cannot stay at home. The parents were very much depressed, so I said, to help them I have to help myself. There was only one way out, to go forward. I was thinking all the time that someone will help me, that something may change. At that time, when he got up to the university, it was just a case. I have got to know that there was a visit to Lourdes planned. The journey was very tedious, 4 days in a coach, but I didn't feel that. Something pulled there,
pulled me there.
I think St. Mary pulled me there. I wanted to pray there, to ask so that the will of God is fulfilled towards me. If I'm not to see and be a decent man, I prefer that in relation to see and be a cad. I asked for the possibility to stand it. It was nearly 3 years. I was going to ask for support for life with a white stick, with Braille, to remain as it was to be. I did not see Lourdes, I did not see the grotto, but I felt something unusual. the bath in the source, even if it was cold in May, I did not feel that. After I went out of the water, it seemed to me that it was like a hot shower. The fog in front of my eyes started to disappear. It was too strong for me to tell anybody about that. It seemed to me it could be something profound impression. I did not tell anybody about that till the moment I came back to Poland. I don't know how long after his arrival, whether it was 2 weeks or a week after his return. He read two letters, P-R, from a distance of a table. When he read that, I went out of home. It was such a shock for me. I did not know whether should I weep or cry. I did not know what to do. Till August, the whole June, July, August, we were at home. I did not send him to a doctor, not because I didn't want it, but I was afraid that the doctor could say that nothing has changed. So, Wojtek, nothing has changed. The nerves are nearly transparent. And then he asked for a table to read. 2470. I can read from backwards. 07102. And from the middle. After his return from Lourdes, he found to me, because I asked him to bring some water, and I wanted him to tell about his impressions. He was very joyful, and he said that he was reading books, whether he could come to confirm it, because he didn't know whether he could do it. So I told him to come for the examination as quickly as possible, and on the 30th July 1986, the joy was immense. There was some reluctance to believe that. I checked with several plates because he was afraid that he knows them by heart. And I found out that the vision of his left eye, he could see everything. And then, after several months, he could see also with his right eye several rows, and it is still now this way. 410 7102 4712 207104. I approached it with much reserve, so it was a joy for today only. Very often I think about it, so what is going to be tomorrow? I don't know whether it should be this way. No one knows what's going to be there tomorrow. I'd like to be this way. I cannot say that it will be a lasting phenomenon. It happened that I see. Why? I don't know. I put this question to God and I hope I will get the answer someday. Until recently, this addiction has not been discussed at all. It seemed to us that this problem is relevant for the States, for the Western Europe. When it came to us, we appeared how large a danger it is. It is not so easy to fight with them. But a number of persons can manage to fight with it, come back to normal life and establish families. Most of it depends on themselves, but also on those who want to help them. The fight for their own life will be given by the heroes of the report that you are going to see in a moment. The poppies. Two, three, four, five, six, seven. I have never thought that it would become such a problem. I was only thinking about preparing an easily available narcotic for me. When I managed to do it, I had a kind of a satisfaction. Now I am shy of it, first of all. I started to take it at the eighth form of the primary school. I have got acquainted with the society. There was a boy in our district. He went to Warsaw. This was a sad story. He went to Warsaw. His mother thought that he was a drug addict, but only took some tablets once. He went to the hospital, and then he got acquainted with people, and it started that way. He brought to our district our Polish heroine. One person, second, third, and it is this way till now. During my whole pregnancy, I was taken. The baby was born on crisis. Well, not on crisis, but because I went out on the 15th, and she was born on the 21st. She was born very small. She weighed 2 kilograms, 200 grams, 51 centimeters. She was warmed in an incubator. The doctor said it was a miracle from the God that she survived and that I survived. I was really taking much, nearly whole output. Don't have any veins, I do injections under the skin. And so how it looks after taking the portion, one gets to himself. He can wash. Several years ago when I started it was a pleasure, and now this is just taking for functioning to survive. It seemed to me that this was a kind of a small group, that we were different, that we think in a different way, we behave in a different way. And now everybody takes who wants it, and he doesn't know where he goes. If I were to start once more, I would never take it. I finished the lyceum, the secondary school, then to a professional school. I graduated it, but I didn't start work because I got into that stuff. Stewed fruit. We were married just after graduation of the professional school. We were having a mushroom producing company. We thought that we would get out of it. We were working not even a whole year. But in the meantime, we came to Gdansk because we could afford it. To buy the merchandise. We thought that it would just be a sort of a jump, but alas, we had to give up our job. We could not continue it. So we came to Gdansk and our wicked existence started. I cannot call it otherwise. It's wicked existence. I stand up in the morning. I'm only thinking whether I have something to do to prepare the drug. We could do it only at night because during the day we are afraid of the police. It's like pure heroin, something even stronger than the one used in the West. It is such a decomposition of organism that one thinks one can live only from one injection to another. He's not interested in anything. He's not interested in books. It is a disappearance of personality. And the worst thing that I'm aware of it, the best way out of it would be suicide, but I'm not. I don't want to leave her. I don't have the right to do it. I'm with her for too long. The last stay in the hospital doesn't help. I think anyhow will accelerate. I think it doesn't have sense to lead the witnesses like that. I thought that there was a great demand for this drug. The demand was immense. In a year, it spread out very quickly to the whole tri-city, to all people who had some contact with drugs. And during subsequent years, it spread out to the whole country. It gave me some satisfaction. I felt that I was simply a drug addict. In particular, when I had an easily available drug, very quickly I became a normal addict who was very ill. I get out into the street, to the Długa Street, when the stuff is sold. I see more and more new faces. They are children, 15, 16 year olds. Well, I started at that age. But when a girl like that comes to me, I chase. I will not drag anybody to it. In particular to a kid, I know what is the danger linked with it. We want to the treatment, get to the treatment once more. But our hospitals are incredibly difficult to survive. The police treat us worse than the thieves or prostitutes. If people are in a center for 2 years and they continue taking, it is either incurable or these are people who simply want to take it more. Or the method of beating. The nurses beat me down. I was completely blue, only because I was walking. It's known that if one is on the crisis, he has to walk, he cannot sleep. I was knotted down and beaten down. I got so nervous. I wanted to go to the hospital and beat anybody of the staff. But she told me that the police would take me and put me to jail. So it finished. During my studies at the medical academy, I could not finish it. They simply didn't want me at those studies. I tried many times more, but I could not agree the studies and taking. I was put to jail for the production. I was sentenced for the production of drugs. I started to feel not well with those drugs. Not only that,
zacząłem się po prostu zmieniać, znaczy powoli, to jednak dosyć długo trwało.
It lasted for quite a long time.
Zacząłem w ogóle,
felt that I was changing
ludźmi, from inside.
I became a lonely person.
Tak, wiem teraz, że przestałem po prostu
I knew now,
odczuwać.
I know now that I gave up feeling.
I
take 6, she takes 2, the proportion about 2 to 1. We take twice a day when we do the stuff for ourselves. We try to confine, to limit the amount of injections. For 2 years I was lying on the ground. After every injection I fell down. When I got up, I started to put the vessels on, and I was preparing more stuff. I came to the conclusion that it's not the method to get out of it. Is 3 times stronger. 2 cubic centimeters. How much should I take from it? It is something in proportional, my dear. Well, I have forgotten.
It is
16, 6, 14.
Ja wziąłem dwójkę.
I
nie było 17.
A couple.
Dobrze było 16.
No.
Okay. No, I take this vitamin medium. The women are usually more nervous. When I have my portion, like under my pillow, I can lie for 12 hours on a crisis. There are very many things which contributed to the situation that I started to think that I don't want to be a drug addict anymore. I did not believe that there is a way out of it. I was thinking about my life that perhaps I'd have to take all the time, perhaps small portions, but I'll have to live. I was fed up with this loneliness. I got a proposition indirectly from Mark Katanski that I could go to a center and cure myself. I came to the conclusion that perhaps at the center there are some different people, so perhaps for some time I will be not alone anymore. It was my only motivation. I was not thinking about curing myself. Only during my stay in the center, in the Monar system, I started to to get to know very important things, that addiction is a curable thing. I saw colleagues who get out of it. The tutors are only colleagues. They used to take drugs. I thought, why should I be worse? I have the same chance as the other. I don't have to be an addict. The moment when I started to believe, I knew that I would not take. One of the reasons for which I would like to cure once more is that I'm aware that finally I will not be able to take these things. I remember a man who has destroyed his veins, so there was a danger of amputation of his leg. His liver was completely destroyed because he started to drink. So he had to take via his abdomen. Today is something unusual. Usually it is about that. In the morning I take with my wife, and then I take between 3 and 6 p.m. And then at about 6 in the morning. We were lying all the morning. Every day one has to spare about 3-4,000 zloty to pay. It is very hard. Sometimes one has to arrange to spare one day to arrange one cubic centimeter. And sometimes it is such a cauchemar that one comes home on a crisis. Young girls start to steal. Some of them start to prostitute themselves. Even in Mono it is said that the addiction in Poland diminishes. But I am of the opinion that it is not diminished. It changes its character. There are more and more young people and still younger people who take different drugs. Some people start smelling different odor-producing substances. There are very many boys in primary schools. I think the problem is getting larger. But it is another wave, a new wave of addiction. But some of them who survive will mature till cure for treatment. Since 1986 in Niepokalanów, there is a festival of Catholic religious films. We're going to present fragments of three films presented during last year, and we invite you to take part in the third festival that's going to be organized from the 15th till 20th May 1988. The copies of films or video cassettes can be delivered to the address of Franciscan monks in Niepokalanów, 96-515 Teresin. See you in the next magazine. Second Festival Grand Prix Niepokalanów 1987. Independent Peasant.
Reżyseria Zygmunt Skoneczny.
Directed by Zygmunt Skoneczny. I will tell you, peasants, at the beginning, that the world changes, but the peasant doesn't change. Who remembers after him? He is overworked, without protection, without defense.
Czy to prawda? Raczej nie. Młodym rośnie, starym schnie. Chłop potęgą, ale cóż.
Peasant is a power, but he is a little bit coward, not very clever, very often not very solid. He is cursing much, very often. He's pushing himself forward. But very often there are no nails available. It's very difficult to mend old roofs, to build new houses. When you have troubles during the production, when you are ill, hunger, when you don't have primitive tools, don't curse the party, neither the government, but try to present your reason to the authorities. And you'll not get into trouble then.
Pierwsza nagroda.
Reverend Jerzy, the first prize, realized by Marian Terlecki. The other people have a profound impression. And what can be said about mother? This is a stone for the rest of my life. I do not wish to those enemies the experience that I have survived. Let Lord Jesus forgive them, and that they repent and think with whom they were fighting, not with my son, they were fighting with God. He was trying to bring joy to anybody. The third prize, Pilgrimage of Faith and Light, directed by Krzysztof Żukowski. We want to arrange in this group one third of those disabled, and one third of those young supporters, and one third of parents. Our aim is to be not only with those people who are mentally disabled, but to branch all the families so that the atmosphere of family life is preserved, to introduce order of the relations with the disabled. A whole community is needed to bring order the relations between normal people.